The claw machine. If you stand on the boardwalk and face east, you are looking into the Atlantic Ocean. If you turn south, you can see the boulders of the jetty and the sharp silhouettes of the flounder fishermen. To the north is the amusement pier, Walkerson Fries, Atlantic Taffy, the friendly gift shop, Louis Chop Suey, and the water balloon game. To the west, you stare directly into my childhood, a penny arcade with showcases of cheap gifts, rows of pokerino tables, skee ball lanes, pinball machines. My mother sits behind the wooden cashier's booth, watching customers plop quarters into a coffin-shaped game with glass sides and a moving crane. They hunch over the button, waiting for the magic moment to make the three draws stop, drop, and lock around a gift. A mustached trucker wants pink foam dice for his girl. A tourist in short sleeves wants to win his bride a beaded pink watch. The 14-year-olds have their slippery eyes on tubes of silver dollars. There are days that the game breaks down. On those days, my dad in chinos and a white undershirt crawls deep inside the claw machine and begins to monkey with the rotors. My mechanical father, razor blade between his teeth, Allen wrench in his hand, tumor in his chest, glasses on his head, ink black hair combed back like Tyrone Power, pretending to be canny Stan Carlisle.